Hi all, I'm Vladimir, you are on the BimmerDoc channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to properly prepare the hardware to work with your BMW. In my latest video, I've shown you how to set up all the needed software to work with the BMW. But of course, there is never enough of only the software, because the hardware part is just mandatory to work. Without that, you just cannot connect to the car. Today, I'll show you how to configure your e-net cable and the original ICOM Next to work with your BMW. ICOM is original BMW diagnostic device used to work with BMWs of all series. E, F, G, I, you name it, so everything. E-net cable consists from one side on OBD2 output and the another side Cat5 output. Actually, e-net cable is the cheapest solution you can buy to connect to a BMW. It can work only with F and G series. Of course, I series, because I series is just electrical vehicles. They were produced at the same time when the F series was produced, so basically it is the same. So e-net cable does not require any configuration, any driver updates, anything. So let's put e-net cable to a side and let's focus on a bit more difficult device, the ICOM Next. At the beginning of the video, I told you that your ICOM does not require... At the beginning of the video, I told you that your ICOM does not need any configuration. You can work with that straight out of the box. It is almost true, because newer version of ISTA, if I remember correctly, the ISTA starting from version 4.28 and newer, will require ICOM software to be updated in order to connect with the newer ISTA. In today's video, I'll show you how to check the version of the software that is inside your ICOM and, of course, how to update. Today, I'll also show how to update ICOM Next, and actually the exactly same procedure will apply to regular ICOM, that will be ICOM A1 or version A2. The softwares can be downloaded in the description of that video. There will be two links for ICOM Next and regular ICOM, so feel free to download those. Those are the latest to the June of 2023. To update your ICOM, you have to power it up in some way, either connecting 12 volts to the outputs of the ICOM or just connecting it to your vehicle. Connecting to the vehicle would be the most easiest way to do that. So let's go downstairs, power up the ICOM and update that. Those of you who do really pay attention have probably noticed that I'm in totally another outfit. But guys, this is not a fashion show, it is technical channel. We're talking about BMWs, software, chiptuning and all that kind of stuff. But why I'm in another outfit? That's because that's way another day, not even another day. For you it was just a second when I was just going downstairs, but actually I have spent a couple weeks trying to solve some issues. More specifically, yes, everything I told you about the ISTA version requires a newer ICOM software and so on, it's absolutely true. So I went downstairs, I downloaded from the BMW official website for the dealers the newest software for the ICOM, installed it to the computer, connected ICOM to the car and tried to start the update, but actually I failed. I thought, okay, might be it was the issue of my computer. I took another one and even the third one with different versions of the ISTA and I was just not able to proceed. So the bottom line, yes, newer ISTA will require the newer software in the ICOM as well. But even more details, newer ICOM will require newer ISTA as well. So they're both connected. So if you are going to update the ICOM to the newest version, it will be 4.something, you will require ISTA version at least 4.39. With older ISTAs, you'll be unable to start the update. You'll see the firmware sign, everything, yes, as it should be, but the update will not start. That's why if you have any issues, just check your ISTA version. Now, when we all together know those new tricks, let's continue updating the ICOM software. I'm sitting in my G30, I have one of my spare ICOMs right in the box. So actually you can see It's original ICOM. I'm using that ICOM for my students when I'm teaching them how to code or program their BMWs and even the advanced course and so on. So that's why I have several ICOMs. I have made all the tests with my ICOM number one. I was successful, updated, everything works fine and so on. So today I'll show you how to update the software as it should be done. So first thing, fire up your computer. And at the moment, even connecting the ICOM is not needed. Download the newest software for the ICOM. You will find the newest version for the ICOM Next and the regular ICOM in the same video in the description. By the way, did you know that if you're watching that video from the phone or from the computer, the description might appear differently to you. So if you're watching from a phone and cannot see the links to download the software, open it through the computer. That's the trick. Download the newest software, that one, so you can see it is for the next version. It is 4.23.10. It is the newest one. And just double click, it will run through the process. It will install the newest software on the computer itself. And actually now, if you connect your ICOM through the ISTA to your computer, ISTA will offer to update the ICOM. Let's do that. I have connected the ICOM to the car through my OBD socket. Actually, you can make exactly the same job as you have seen in my Instagram. If you haven't, for example, here is the picture. You can connect the ICOM not to the car, but just giving it 12 volts, so it will be powered up. That will be also enough. Before we are going to update the software of the ICOM itself, open up the IoT radar. This is the software, so you can determine the IP address of the ICOM. Let's go inside the ICOM and see what software it is over there. Just copy the IP address, open your browser. With the browser, you'll need extension, port, that one, and it will be always that one. It will ask you the login and the password. Login and the password for all the ICOMs in the world is exactly the same. You can see those on the screen at the moment. Over here, what do we need? Actually, in that menu, you can make, for example, the self-test for the ICOM, and doing all those things. For example, let's start self-test. And click here to see the results, so we can see everything works, blah, 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 and so on. So everything is fine, good. But actually, the thing we need to do, first, pay attention how the overall menu looks like. It is the old style, and after the update, it will be the way newer style. If you press update the firmware, you can see the software of the version. Software version of the ICOM is 3.15.03. After the update, it should be, I'll show you in a second, it will be exactly the same one. It will be 4.23.10. So over here you will see the differences. So let's do it. And exactly as I told you, you're starting your ISTA Plus. And it is important, so your ISTA Plus should be newer. Recently I have released a video where I was telling you how to update, not update, how to install all the needed software to work with the BMWs. And over there I was recommending you the ISTA version 4.28. I still think it is very good ISTA version. At the moment I have installed version 4.39. After a couple months, you can ask me for the feedback, is it good stable version or not? At the moment, I was using that for ish 1 month, and I'm totally okay with that. But to give the better expertise, more time is needed. So in the ISTA, go over here. It is Connection Manager. Over here, you can see the state, the firmware is written there. It means that we have installed some software to the computer, but now it's needed to be deployed into the ICOM itself. Also, if you don't see your ICOM over there in the settings, make sure that vehicle interface is set to that kind of option. If it's not, please do that. But let's continue to the software update itself. If you highlight it, you press configure vehicle interface, and ISTA will offer you to start the update itself. I'm pressing that. It tells us that process cannot be interrupted. If you will interrupt the process, most likely you will break your ICOM. So please do not do that. I'm pressing the OK. It tells that after the software has been updated, the ICOM will make a restart. How you can determine that? At the moment, over here, have a look. You can see those, just the green is flashing. When it will be updating, the flash, all the bulbs will go to red and will blink. You'll see that in a second. And when they will turn green again, it means the ICOM is operational. Pressing OK. And now it shows update ICOM firmware. I will turn the ICOM towards you. So actually you will see those bulbs. If my phone is just focusing sometimes to my face or to the ICOM itself, it doesn't matter, but I guess you can see the update process is happening now. If you will lose the power now, you will break your ICOM. The only way to restore that will be using the programmer. So please do not disconnect the Ethernet cable, or the power supply from the car. At the same time, you can see the small screen of the ISTA. It tells that the ICOM will be restarted. You can see the green bulb appear there, so it made a restart. The process should take around 4 to 5 minutes. If you are not sure, just start the timer and wait for those 5 minutes. Believe me, if you will hurry up and ruin your ICOM, you'll waste way more time. In the ISTA, you can see the ICOM has disappeared and it appeared again with the IP address, and now you can see the state is free. It means the ICOM has restarted and software update has been finished. I'll put the ICOM to the side. We can actually close the ISTA now. Let's open the IP idle radar again. Copy the IP address and go to the browser. Extension port will be exactly the same. Password will be the same. Do you see the difference now on your screen? The menu looks way different. And now update firmware, and you can see the ICOM software has been updated. Let's see how the self-test looks like. It shows actually the last result they saved in the ICOM. We can start self-test again and see the results again. So everything is okay. The LAN link speed shows 100 megabytes, but actually original ICOM Next can go up to 1 gigabyte per second. It is needed to update the newest G series. It is not required, so that speed is not required at the moment, but it's just to make the thing a bit more future-proof. I have manually reduced speed up to 100 megabytes per second to enhance the interoperability between different cars. For example, sometimes the BMW X3 in F25 chassis, if you want to work with that, you will have issues if you haven't set up your network card properly. What else should I add about updating the software of your ICOM? Be aware that if you will update your ICOM software to the newest version, you might have issues working with the older ISTA versions. Just take it as a fact. So do not hurry with updating anything, because reversing back might be a bit difficult. Wait a bit until, for example, I have tested the ISTA version 3.49 and I can tell you, yes guys, it is stable. Only then you can go and update your ICOM. Of course, I'll make a couple tests with the newest ICOM software and with the older ISTAs. For example, the version I have recommended you previously, 4.28, and I can give you some feedback later in the comments. So just ask me, hey Vladimir, have you made some tests? And I'll reply in the comments if I have already done those or not. I have showed you only one way how to update the software. Actually, there could be another way also. From the same menu, you can actually upload the image file of the ICOM. It might be required to update the older versions of the ICOM. If you do have those older images of the ICOM, different versions, you can send them to me. It's not a problem for me. I can upload those to my cloud and put the link into the description to share with other BimmerDoc channel fans. So how should that older style ICOM software look like? Actually, if you go to homepage, update firmware, and actually over here, you can see you can choose the file, you can choose the system or application, and we are choosing the file, you can upload those directly to the ICOM. The rest of the process would look like the same. The only difference is that you will not need ISTA to update the ICOM anymore. You can make directly everything from that console menu. And as I say again, it might be required, for example, if you need to update the software of the ICOM that is just not supported anymore by the newest ISTA, for example, the ICOM A1, the first one. And actually, guys, that's it. That's everything I wanted to show you about the ICOM update. Just some rules. Do not hurry with the update. You'll be unable to downgrade that. Just read the comments through for the experience of the other guys who have already done that procedure, if it's recommended or not recommended. Do not interrupt the power supply of the ICOM during the update process, because you'll just break it. And the only way to recover that will be through the programmer. And it will be not as straightforward as update through the ISTA. If you're enjoying watching my videos, feel free to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet. Also hit a like and leave the comments, and see you next time. Bye.